This video is part of Lesson 1 in the course God's Way of Salvation. In this video, why study salvation? To be balanced, to be biblical, to be a blessing.
Hi there, thanks for joining this class, God's Way of Salvation. My name is Kees Molenaar and I will be your instructor in this course. My passion is to pass on the blessings that I've received from God to other people like you. I'm thankful for the parents I had who taught me biblical truths, taught me to seek the Lord even when I was still young. I'm also thankful for the opportunity I had to study theology. And afterwards, I had the privilege of teaching Bible at several colleges in African countries, where I lived together with my wife and our children. Today, I'm a pastor and teacher of an international church, where we have people from all over the world attending for worship service. So, I'm happy you are here, and my prayer is that you will be blessed by these lessons and are also able to pass it on to others that God brings on your way. So this first lesson, we look at the question, why study salvation? Why teach about salvation? And I will use an example from our daily life. In my life, I've made quite a number of road trips. And today it sounds easy. You have your GPS or you have Google Maps with you. And as long as you have network, you are good to go. But still, often I would use a road map in preparation of my journey. Why would I do that? Well, it will give me an overview of the whole journey that I'm taking, where I'm going. I could see where are the steep mountains, where the road will be more difficult. I can find out that there are stretches without a fuel station. Or I can even see these are deserted areas. I shouldn't stop there for a picnic. Or I would look up the history of the towns I'm passing through and look at the people that live there and serve there. And so it would enrich my trip if I am better prepared. Without my map and without my preparation, I wouldn't have an idea where I'm going, and I would certainly not have enjoyed it as much as with my preparation. Now, that picture of a roadmap, I want you to keep in mind as we are going through this course, God's Way of Salvation. Salvation is like a journey that you are taking. It starts at one point in your life, and it will carry on, and it will take some time. It's a journey. Now, this course is the roadmap for that journey. For some people, it's a simple thing. Salvation. Oh, yeah, I remember the day I accepted Jesus as my Savior. That's salvation, right? For others, it's more complicated. They have struggled for some time. Yeah, I know. I came to trust in Jesus. But at some points in my life, it seemed I lost it all or my faith disappeared. And even right now, maybe you're not so sure whether you will actually reach your final destination of salvation. So that's why I want to take you along and I want to be your guide as we study salvation. So I'm giving three answers to the question, why do we study salvation? The first answer is, we need to study salvation in order to be balanced. Balanced in our thinking, in our understanding. First of all, we need to keep God in the center of our thinking. With the topic of salvation, it's easy to be just focused on what I get out of it or what you get out of it. Peace, happiness, comfort, and these are good biblical things that we receive from God. But we need to be sure to keep God in the center of our thinking about salvation. He is our final destination. Maybe you were thinking, heaven is my final destination, or salvation itself is the final destination. If only I could be saved, then I'm in. That's what I mean with balance. We need to keep God in the center of salvation. Not what we receive from God, but who God is for us. And our relationship with Him is key to salvation. We also need to be balanced in the sense that we stay alert to the power and the danger of sin. These powers, these dangers are real. And if you just start on your journey and you are not aware of any difficulties that could cross your path, they can take you by surprise. And then you are not prepared. So we need to be balanced in our expectations. Sin is real and the struggle is hard. We need to be ready to defend ourselves for sin and against sin. And I would say there is need of balance as we study the way that God is dealing with people. Now, I'm not saying that God has just one method and that He follows the same path with every individual in any time, in any place in this world. And yet, from the Bible, we get certain directions. We can learn of a certain method that God follows, and it helps us to study these. What is God's normal way of working? How can we recognize that actually God is at work in our lives? It helps us, for example, to understand that salvation is a calling. We are called to believe in Jesus. And at the same time, and that's the balance, salvation is a gift, something that God is giving to us. Now, my conviction is, if you keep this balance, you will see that salvation is a lot more enjoyable. You will get more out of it when you know what God is doing. We will admire the love of God that He is giving to us. We will admire the care that God is taking to save us. And it helps us to see how God worked in the lives of other people before and how He is working in our lives. So, the first reason was we study salvation in order to be balanced. And I also believe it's biblical to study salvation. So throughout the course, we will be sitting down sometimes together to study the Bible. So I welcome you to open your Bible and follow along. I'm explaining that we study salvation in order to be balanced, but also to be biblical. It is biblical to have a broad understanding of what salvation is. It's not always a small thing in the Bible either. For example, in this passage in Ephesians chapter 1. In Ephesians chapter 1, we have on the one hand the big picture of things, of salvation. For example, if you look with me in verse 3, we read, "Blessed be the God and Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, who has blessed us in Christ Jesus with every spiritual blessing in the heavenly places." He talks about every spiritual blessing wherewith we are blessed by God our Father. A little further in the same chapter, in verse 11, Paul talks about we have obtained an inheritance. One big word to indicate all of salvation, an inheritance that we have received. And you can see that later on in verse 14, that same word comes back again, that we have received the Holy Spirit as a down payment of our inheritance. And then it says in verse 14, until we have acquired possession of it. I'm pointing this out because it shows that the inheritance is truly given to us. That is the certainty of salvation. And yet, there will be time passing by until we fully possess it, receive it. Now, in the same passage that we have here in chapter 1 of Ephesians, we see many of the other things we will talk about in this course. So you can see that I didn't just bring it in, but it's here in the Bible. For example, in verse 5, We read about God who predestined us. We read in verse 4 already, He chose us in Him, that is Christ, before the foundation of the world. This is more the behind the scenes that we will talk about later that God is doing. We read even in these verses why God chose us, what God wanted to achieve by choosing us. For example, we see in verse 4 that God's intention was that we should be holy and blameless before Him. Or a little further in verse 7, it talks about that we should have redemption through the blood of Jesus. So all these details are put together in one chapter to teach us that salvation is not just one or the other. It's not just forgiveness of sins, or that we were chosen by God, or that we will be in heaven one day. All this is part of the bigger picture of salvation. It doesn't just talk about what God is doing, but also about what we are doing. We get to know the love of God, we read in this chapter. Because, as verse 12 says, we have placed our hope in Christ. We have placed our hope in Christ. Because we heard the word. This is the practical element of hearing the word of God. And we have believed it, and we have received the Holy Spirit as a seal or down payment. Now there's one word I have not touched. Maybe you have already seen it as you were reading through this passage. It comes back again and again. And that's the word glory or praise. Look in verse 6, for example. It says, to the praise of His glorious grace. You find the same word again in verse 12. That we should be to the praise of His glory. And finally in verse 14, that's how it concludes. To the praise of His glory. That's what I mean with salvation is not about us. In the end, it's all about that we live and learn to live and to learn to behave and think and believe all to the praise of His glory. That we are full of the greatness of God and desire to express our appreciation and our worship for God in our words. So it's not only to be balanced that we study salvation, but as you can see from this chapter in Ephesians 1, it's also biblical to study the many elements and many sides of salvation. Then finally, we also study salvation because it will be a blessing for us and you will be a blessing for others as well. So in this lesson, we are looking at why study salvation. And we have already seen it's important to have balance in our thinking. It is biblical to study salvation to get a big picture of what God is doing in our lives. And I also believe that if you study salvation in this course and from the Bible, you will be a great blessing to other people around you. You yourself will be encouraged. You will have a much better understanding of where you are in your life. You will know that this is part of a bigger story. This is one part of the road, and you know there's other parts coming up, and you've already covered quite some distance. It will help you to be an encouraged person as a Christian. You will be more excited, more happy, because you know what God is doing and has already done for you. I also believe that this way you will be prepared for the hardship that is coming, no doubt, in your lives. So understanding salvation will make you a blessing for other people around you. You know, in fact, you will become like a tour guide. You will be someone who has traveled that road, who has been in these places, and now you are able to accompany others, to come alongside others and say, hey, I know where we are going. I've been there, I've seen these places before. I know that here you can have a flat tire or you can have a challenge of there's no fuel station, we are running out of gas. You know that, you know these challenges are coming. And as you have that knowledge and that experience, You will be a guide to others that are new on this path of salvation. And really, my prayer is that as you study this course, you will be sharing this with people in your family, friends, people you meet on the street or at work, maybe in your church as you're preaching or leading a Bible study. God will use whatever you learn here and make you a blessing for others as well. You know, salvation, as I'm saying, it's a journey, and it helps to see the bigger picture of things. Sometimes you get stuck at one part in your life and you can't see over the wall, and you don't know where this is all going. And sometimes you feel desperate and say, God, is this really the salvation that you promised me? Now, this study, this course will help you to understand that it's really God's journey. God is traveling from one place to the other, and He's taking you along, and you will be taking along others as well.
You have been watching the video, Why Study Salvation, in the course, God's Way of Salvation. We hope to see you again next lesson.